In Unity, it's possible to control the volume of one element in your audio mix based on the volume of another. This is called ducking, and we achieve this using the duck volume effect. I've got a simple scene set up here with three musical parts, a kick drum, bass line, and arpeggio. These are all assigned to game objects, which have audio source components, which are assigned to different outputs in our audio mixer. The kick has its own group, and the synthesizers, the bass line and arpeggio, are both routed to the synthesizer group. What we're going to do is we're going to cause the volume of the synthesizers to duck based on the volume of the kick drum when it strikes. This is also called sidechain compression. To begin, I'm going to add a duck volume effect using the Add drop-down menu. Now that the duck volume effect has been added, I'm going to send some audio signal to it, and I'm going to do this using the Send effect. I'm going to click Add and choose Send. Now, in the inspector, I'm going to choose the bus for the send to be routed to. In this case, that's going to be synthesizer's duck volume. Now that we've set up our routing, we're going to set the send level. Because the input on the duck volume effect does not route its signal back to the main volume, we can turn up this send without adding any volume to our mix. This is a typical behavior for a sidechain input on a compressor. With the volume turned all the way up, now the full amplitude of our kick will reach the duck volume effect when it plays. Let's listen to the scene first. Now, even though we've configured our scene, we're still not hearing any gain reduction from the duck volume. If we click on the duck volume effect, we can configure its parameters. The threshold is the volume at which gain reduction will begin to occur. So our input signal, in this case our kick drum, will need to exceed a threshold of negative 10 decibels before we start to apply any gain reduction. Let's listen to that in action. We're going to play. Turn on edit and play mode so that we can change the parameters. And we're going to slowly reduce the threshold. And so you can hear, as we reduce the threshold, we start to hear that pumping, breathing effect because the amplitude of the kick drum is now causing our duck volume effect to lower the amplitude or volume of the synthesizer group. Now we can move on to our next parameter, which is called the ratio. The ratio determines how much gain reduction will be applied once the threshold is triggered. One easy way to think about this is that it's the amount of gain reduction, which is applied once the threshold is exceeded. Next, we have the attack time and the release time. The attack time is once the threshold has been triggered, how quick is the onset of the gain reduction? The release time is the opposite. Once the attack phase is completed, so in this case after 26 milliseconds, the release time begins to release the compression or the gain reduction. And so in this case, after 100 milliseconds, we will no longer be reducing volume, so we'll be back to our original signal strength. The makeup gain is simply an additional volume control that allows us to make back up some of the gain that we've reduced. In this case, because we want to have a pronounced ducking effect where we hear the volume getting quieter, we're going to leave the makeup gain at zero, which means that no change in volume is going to be applied. The knee controls the behavior of the threshold. At a very low or hard knee, we're going to get a linear transition from once the threshold is crossed, we're going to begin applying gain. If we increase the knee value or soften it, we're going to see that we're going to have a much more smooth transition as the gain reduction is applied. And it's actually possible at high knee values, as you can see from the graph changing, to begin reducing gain even before the threshold has been tripped. As we approach the threshold at a soft knee value, we're going to begin to see some gain reduction even before we've exceeded the threshold. The sidechain mix allows us to blend between the affected and the unaffected signal. At 100%, we're listening to only the signal which is being processed by the duct volume. At zero, we're going to be listening to only the original signal. In addition to being able to adjust the parameters via the sliders, we can also adjust the parameters by clicking directly on the graphic. If we click on the white line here representing the threshold, we can actually drag horizontally to adjust the threshold value. By dragging vertically, we can adjust the knee, and you'll see we have this nice representation of how the knee is affecting the threshold. If we drag to the left of the line, we can adjust the makeup gain, and if we drag to the right of the line, we can adjust the ratio.